Now that we've covered the account settings, we can move on to the emails that WooCommerce sends. Head to WooCommerce, Settings, then Emails to begin. You'll be greeted with a table of the emails WooCommerce can send. We'll come back to these shortly. We first need to cover the general email settings further down, kicking things off with the email sender options section. You can set the from name and from address. These are important to set as it's what your customers see in their inbox. For example, with these settings, it would show that they've received an email from WooCommerce videos from the videos at woocommerce.com email address. Next, under email template, we can customize how your emails look. You can enter a URL for a header image. We'd recommend uploading one under media, add new, then copy its URL and paste it in the header image field. You can also customize the text in the footer text field. This appears at the bottom of every email sent. You can then choose the base color, background color, email body background color, and email body text color. You can see how your choices look at any time by selecting the click here to preview your email template link. Just a quick note, if you want to do further and more complex customizations to the email templates, it's best to copy the email templates into your theme. Copy the emails folder from woocommerce/templates/emails into your themes folder at your theme/woocommerce/emails. Be aware that this then overrides any customizations from the email template settings we just went over. With that out of the way, select Save Changes and we can move on. Let's head back to the top of the email settings. Like mentioned, these are the individual emails WooCommerce can send. For the most part, each email has the same fields. You can enable or disable each one, set the recipient and subject fields, and more. From here, you can also quickly see the content type as well as the recipient. The emails that say customer mean these emails are sent to the customer. Let's take a peek at one so you can get familiar with them. To head into an email settings, either select the email title or the gear icon to the right. In here, you can start by enabling or disabling the email from being sent. Though with the new order email, let's assume the majority of store owners want to receive this when they get a new order. You can then choose the email address or addresses to send this email to in the recipients field. If you add more than one email address, be sure you separate them by commas. Next up, the subject field is what your recipients see in their inbox. The default shows the site title, then new customer order with the order number and order date at the end of the subject. You can set this to any text and information your heart desires. The email heading field works much like the subject, but is normally not seen by customers. An email header contains more technical information that isn't necessarily important for this video. Our last setting, email type, lets you choose what format to send your email as, the options being plain text, HTML, or multipart. We'll leave it set to the default HTML so we get our logo, styles, and colors. Finally, you'll notice a couple of options under the email type options. You can easily copy over just that email's template into your theme to do more complex customizations than the settings offer. If you've already copied the entire WooCommerce/templates/emails folder into your theme, you'd see a delete template file button instead of a copy template file button. You can also select view template to view the code for that email. And you'd be able to edit the template if it was already copied into your theme. We wouldn't recommend editing the template's code directly from here though. If you do edit the template from within WordPress, just be certain you have backups of these templates and select Save Changes once you've made your customizations. As mentioned earlier, the remaining emails have the fields we covered above. Enable or disable, set the recipient, subject, and so on. Once you've gone through each email settings, you're all set. Feel free to place orders on your store, issue refunds, etc. to test them out. We also have a great FAQ section about any email troubles you may be having, so check that out if needed. As always, thanks for watching.